Hey guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. This is our next session in Apache Spark series, and currently we are discussing the Spark SQL module. In our last session, we have discussed how to create a data frame and how we can use SQL-like queries in our data frames and what are the views, temp views. If you are interested in that topic, please find that link in the I button. Now, moving ahead from there in our official documentation, there comes a topic of how to create a data set. So there are basically few ways that you can create a data set, and in this video we'll discuss all of that how you can create a data set, that how you can create a data set from like some collections, how you can create a data set from some other data frame, from some RDD. So all those different ways and how to interoperate between data frame, data sets, RDDs, all those things we are going to discuss in this session. So let's jump to our IntelliJ. This is the code that we discussed in our last session. So let me remove all this. Let the Spark session be as it is. So let's see first how you can create a data set normally without any case classes and all like what we discussed earlier. First, very simply to start from the basics, how you can create a data set. So that's all. Suppose you have a data in some collection and you are being asked to create a data set. How you can do that? Just create a val, let it be a simple DS, and let's say you have a sequence of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's it. Okay, so how you can create a data set out of this sequence? You can just mention a dot 2DS, that's it. This is how you can create a data set. Why this is giving an error? To interoperate between all these RDDs and collections, you need Spark implicits to be imported. So import Spark dot implicits, everything from there. So this error is gone. And to access this data set, simply simple DS dot show. So that's how simple it is. Try to run it. So simple data set we are getting. So this was the first way, creating a data set out of some collection. So now let's say you have multiple values and you want to create a data set. As we discussed in our data sets video, we can do that by case classes. So let's see using case classes how you can create a data set. So let's create a simple case class. Case class in this case are used because if you have to do a pattern matching to your data, whatever you are going to put in your data set, and you want to, as data set, all the values are your JVM objects. So to define those type of objects, you can do that by case classes. You can create a class and then create objects of that class that will be JVM objects, and then put it into your data sets. So creating a case class is simple. You have to mention case, class, the class name, let's say person, and then the values in that whatever you are your data has. Let's say we are going to same way our other examples. We have a name that is a string, then we have age that can be a date. So simply now we have a class. Now we have to create different objects of this class. So let first object be person one. And what we need here is person, and to give the values person. So person first is name, that is a string. Let us pass a string, and the age can be the int because it is expecting int. So let us create another person two, anything, Ankit, he's 30. So we have a case class and we have two objects of that class. These two objects, you can again, you can have a series of these objects if you have multiple rows. For this example, just for the concept I am telling you, this is not how usually the data is put into your data sets, because you cannot create every row like this different variable, but I'm just telling how that case classes, what importance they signify into your creating a data set by when you are using a case class. What is the need of that? So need of that is creating a class and creating the objects, and that objects you can refer as the rows of that data set. Now you have objects of the same case class person. How you can create a data set out of this? Let me create a data set, case class DS, and again same way as we created a sequence, this sequence signifies the difference rows. This collection, you can understand, the sequence, the first element of this sequence was the first row of the data set, and similarly the second row. Same way here we want is first object to be the first row of this data set, then the second one. So we can define it same way, sequence of what, in this case not the numbers like 1 2 3 4 5, but the objects of this case class, person 1, person 2. So you can see here it is something what same as we discussed in the collection one. Now again same way, 2 DS and case class DS dot show. If you run this, you can see those two objects are now the rows of the data set that is created. That is a case class DS. So this is the second way how you can create a data set. Now coming to one more way, suppose you have a data frame and you have to create a data set out of that. Like in this example, we have this data frame DF. So let us create a data set out of this DF. So what was there in this DF? I believe we were reading from data JSON, and this also has name and ages. So we already have created a case class which has name and age. So we don't need to create a different case class. The same case class we can use. But for this, let's say this is the third example. Let me remove this altogether. Remove this as well. So now we have a data frame. So what we can do, this data frame we can superimpose onto this case class, because this data frame will return us the names and ages, and for creating a data set out of that data frame, whatever values, if they are matching, in this case they are matching, that is why from the same data frame we want to create a data set. So what we can do, this is a data frame. Once we define where we have to get the data into a data frame, after that we can mention as keyword, we can pass the name of the class that we want to superimpose, like person. So what will happen here is this data frame will be created, but onto that data frame this case class will be implemented. So now this complete thing DF is now a data set. You want to see DS dot show. So you can see here again we are getting the same output. Now coming to one more way, interoperating between RDDs and the data sets. How you can create a data set from an RDD. So for creating a data set out of an RDD, there are basically two options. First is, if you have a case class already for data sets, you need a type of the objects that are to be inserted into that data set. So if in case similarly you have a case class already, you can define what type of values are there. So in that case, if you have a case class already, then you can use the same case classes onto your RDD. This is known as a reflection method. Like here they have told, inferring the schema using reflection. So this is nothing but if you have an RDD, let me execute this so that it will be more clear to you. Let me copy the same thing so as to save the time. So we have a data frame, similarly the path is different for us, people.txt. Let me copy here, and the people.txt has some text that I have mentioned, cat, dog, mouse, and they are splitting that by comma and map. For each value, for each row in that RDD, they are taking a person class, that is small p in our case. I think I have removed that. Let me get it back. Okay, so what we are doing here is this: for each row in our RDD, that is, first value will be cat, 10, second is dog, 20, and third will be mouse, 30. So for each attribute, you can understand this is attribute 1, this is 2, this is 3 in an RDD. We are creating an object of this case class with the attributes of that particular row. So first object will be attribute 0, attribute 1. First object will be attribute 0, attribute 1, and same object will be created of a person class, which will be the name and the age. So in this way, to this RDD, you are implementing the case class person by creating objects, by doing a map and creating objects row by row of that particular case class and creating a data frame out of that. So that is simply how you can create a data set or data frame out of an RDD. And one more thing to notice here, as they have mentioned in the documentation, as we already told you that all the Spark context features you can access from the Spark session as well. So same way, you can see that Spark session object also has the Spark context class. So in this case, when we had to create an RDD, we use the same Spark session, and from that Spark session, we use the Spark context class that we need to create an RDD. And if you do not have case class already, you can also mention that manually using the struct type field. The method is same. I don't want to repeat everything. Just you can follow this documentation, because the method is same. You can see here, suppose we have a schema string. It has only the column names that we can map to an RDD elements. So same way, we are reading this particular schema string. So struct type is a class with the help of which you can define a structured schema. This struct type includes struct field objects. The struct fields, you can consider the column types. So here, for any struct field, you can name the struct field like name, age, and define the type of it. Here they are doing a map because they have the column names, not the type of it. And so they are using a map, and for each field name, they are creating a struct field, that is a column, giving the column name that we had already splitted and defining the type of it. So when you use a struct type for defining the schema, for that you have to use the create data frame function of Spark session again. This is also what Spark session provides us. So once your schema is ready, then you can use Spark session dot create data frame, which takes two arguments. First will be your row RDD, whatever RDD you have taken, and followed by the schema that you have just created with the help of struct type. So that was the another way that where you can define the schema programmatically and create your data frame or data set out of an RDD. So this was all about how to interoperate between RDD, data frame, data sets. If you still have any question, please let me know in the comment section, and please do subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. See you in my next video. Thank you.